started warming up. All right, I already got that ready. I got my music ready to go. So we're doing chest and back and shoulders. So shake it out. Shake it out. Make it dynamic. Pull it open. Pull it open. I'm sore. And like, this is what's going to happen, you guys. This last couple of weeks that we have left, you're going to be sore like every day, because the DOMS is going to last you 3 to 4 days and you're going to be sore. So you can expect soreness. My butt cheeks were so sore after Saturday. I couldn't even sit. It hurt. I thought I had butt implants in. My biceps are sore today. I mean, and that's from Tuesday. I mean, again, or from Saturday. 5, 6, 7, 8. Just keep going. We're just trying to warm those shoulders up. 5, 6, 7, 8. Now reach, reach. Stretch it out. 8, 4, 3, 2, 1. Push it out side to side. We have back as well. So we're doing push-pull. Push-pull is working the front and the back part of the muscle. So we're working chest and back, which is push and pull. And then we're gonna do push and pull for our shoulders, which is the front part of your shoulders, back part of your shoulders, rear delts. Now point those thumbs back and squeeze. 6, 7, 8. Now pump it back for 8. Squeeze the elbows together. Now turn it out. 8, 7, 6. Squeeze your shoulder blades. 3, 2, 1. Now pump it back. Squeeze those elbows back there. Okay, let's do a couple push-ups. We're just gonna do a drop set, okay? We're gonna do 12, drop off 2, and go all the way down to 2 push-ups. Okay, you can do whatever grip you want. You can use your push-up bars. You can do incline. Hands on a bench will be easier. Okay. Here we go. You can do them on your knees, but make sure whatever you're doing, you have good form. 12. 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it out. A couple seconds here to recover. And then we're gonna do 10. Man, my biceps are sore from Saturday. All right, here we go. I'm gonna go a little bit wider with my stance now with my arms. Step it out. 10. 8. We need to warm this chest up good. We're lifting heavy weight. I'm going to be using my bar over there. You won't be able to see me. I'm sorry, but I'm doing a chest press. Trust me. Here we go. 8. 8. Out. Is it getting easier? I don't think so. We have 6. This is a lot of push-ups, but again, it's going to get everything warm, our shoulders too. Okay. Now, I'm going to do fingertips in. 6, 5. Okay. Shake it out. Now I'm gonna do fingertips out. We only have 4. 4. And my last two, I'm gonna do the same. Shake it out. This is it. Whew. One, up, two, up. Okay, we're good. All right, so I'm gonna add weight onto mine, 5%. So it's about 8 pounds for 10%. So I'm gonna do 4 pounds, which really I'm gonna do five. So I'm gonna add 5 pounds on, and I'm gonna be doing my chest press. Remember, flat bench, straight up, elbows come out at the sides. Press it straight up. We've done this last week, and back down. I'll be over here. We only have 7 reps. 7 reps, not 8, 7. We shaved 1 rep off. We're increasing weight. Okay, here we go. Yep. The dumbbell comes into the, and make sure your neck is not hanging down like this. Don't do this. Keep your shoulders back. I'm using a 40. 7 reps. Okay. And you can use the lunge stance as well. Again, we're looking for that flat back, okay? Here we go. 7. Full extension down, 6. Three, two, one. And I don't want to rock too much. If I'm rocking too much, my weight's too heavy. Okay, other side. Now I'm going to try to beat my total failure reps because I'm not adding weight. So when it comes to total failure, seven. Okay. Guess what? We have a decline set up. If you don't want to do decline, you don't have to. Okay, which was that? Oh, that was the chest press. Oh yeah, that's what I was saying. I'm going to go over there and do my chest press. So what I was doing over there that you couldn't see was the one that's on your list, chest press. Just press up and press down. Okay, Sunshine, sorry, I didn't see that. All right, so I'm going to grab a 15-pound dumbbell. Yes. It was 7 reps of chest press over there. I'll aim the camera next time. Okay. Now, you don't have to do decline. I'm doing decline because I have a decline bench. If you don't want to do decline, you don't have to. You can do a regular sit-up. We have 1 minute. Go. I am doing decline. You can do regular. You can do crunches. I have a 15-pound dumbbell for resistance. You don't have to have that. Exhale, roll it down carefully. I'm taking the arms out of it by holding the dumbbell close to my chest. Let your abs pull you up. Tuck your hips as you're rolling up. Round your back on the way down. Take your hip flexors out of it. Okay. Almost done. 1 minute. And done. Okay. There we go. Second set. All right. So then you know we're doing this chest press. I'm doing it over here with my straight bar. Okay. Over here, I'm going to start with the chest press. 7 reps. Second set. All right. Chest press. Here we go. Once you're in position, go ahead and start. Lower the bar down or the dumbbells straight across the chest. The elbows come out. Okay, horizontal row. I use my bench for my arm. There we go. Flat back, neck in alignment too. Don't be dragging your neck down, just looping it down. Don't twist your upper body. And 7. Woo! Ha! Switch sides. Full extension down. Don't cut it short. Your elbow or your shoulder will dip down a little bit when you extend. 7. We're targeting the upper portion of your back. Okay, decline sit up. If you want decline. 1 minute. Here we go. Nice and slow and steady. Good form. Think about tucking those hips as you come up and exhale. Inhale all the way down. Roll it down. Take the arms out of it. Make your core do the work by holding the dumbbell right by your chest. Okay, last one. All right. Whew! All right, sunshine. Catch your breath. We're going in for the round 3. Now, in this superset, we have 4 rounds. Okay, 4 sets. Catch your breath. Anything that's tight, stretch it out. I'm going over there to do my chest press. Okay, 7 reps again. Good form. You should feel it on the last 2. All right. The chest press. Press it up and lower it down. Don't cheat it. All the way down to the chest and then press it up. So we're working push muscle right now, pushing it. And there we go. Oh, it's so funny. You can hear my weights rattling because my arms are shaking. Okay, now, horizontal row. So now we're working the pulling muscle. facing down. 7 reps. Remember, work on the form. Don't go too fast. I know it seems like no recovery at all because we're working, but you're recovering from working your chest and back when you're doing your sit-ups. So it gives us, we have to wait about a minute and a half for recovery from the muscle to do the next set. So this way, while we're waiting for the minute and a half, we're actually able to get our core work done. So 1 minute core, 30 seconds rest, and then over to the machine or to your barbell, dumbbells, whatever you're using, and we're gonna do our last set, total failure. Look at your number if you didn't add weight. You're gonna try to beat that number if you can, even if it's by one. Write it down. All right, since I added weight, I'm targeting for 8 reps, okay? 8 reps for me. I added weight onto mine. This one, I'm going to try to beat my total failure from last time, which was 10. So, if I can get 10, 11 would be great. Here we go. 2 minutes just to get the number. It's a slow process, but it's worth it because you don't get injuries. I've, knock on wood, yet to have one yet, so
Always remember your form comes first. Racing and run right down. Okay. Whew. Now we have incline. You can do this on your ball. You can do this on your ball. Again, we did this last week, so I think you guys should remember, probably. We're doing chest flies. Two dumbbells. Arms are not locked out stiff. Open and close. Open and close. Hug the tree on the way up. Palms will face each other. Okay? Here we go. All right, I'm going with 25. I'm adding weight on. All right? Because I got 11. All right. So. Again, if I got over 10, we're gonna make sure we mount properly. Put them on your lap, roll them down with them on your chest, then press them up together. Make sure you press them up together. It will help support your shoulders. All right. Now, open and close carefully. Do not hyperextend your shoulders. As soon as if you were on the ground that you touched the ground, you come back up. Don't go past, okay. Push up, open, and close. The elbows will bend as you're opening and closing, but you're squeezing it together at the top. Four, five, six. Exhale when you push it together. One more, and seven. Keep them together. Lower the elbows slowly onto your lap and roll up. Okay. Back. We're gonna do an underhand row. Now, I'm gonna keep my weight. It was 40. I only got 10. Like a same thing as last time. I'm trying to beat my total failure. So, underhand row, one arm. Now, we're gonna be more, look at my back. It's a 45 degree angle. It's not flat back like this, okay? When I pull it, I'm at a 45. Okay, one arm, then the other. Underhand grip means my palms are gonna face up. Okay, here we go. Pull, two, pull it in towards the waist, three, four, five, six, seven. Whew. Switch. Okay. Just a different view. Again, once you grab it, hand on the knee, pull it back. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. All right, recovery ab. Woo! All right, side bend. One side, we're gonna alternate, then the other. We're gonna have two dumbbells. Or actually, no, we're gonna do one side first, and then we'll do the other side in the second set. I forgot we only have two sets. Okay, weights down. Now, don't lock out. Don't lock out your knees. Push, let it go down, pull it up. Let it go down, pull it up. Just work on form, and oh, you can totally feel this. Whatever we did on abs, whoo. Saturday, I'm feeling it. Pull, oh, let it slide down there. Resist it, pull it up. Pull it up, you're going side bend. Here's another view. Side. I'm not leaning down. Right down the side. Oh. Pull it up. Not with your arm, with your core. Your arm stays hanging. Okay. One more. And done. Whew. Keep that weight right there. Okay. Get into position. We have these couple of seconds here left. Two, get ready. Set two, we only have three sets, all right? Three sets in this round. All right, catch your breath, inhale. Exhale, then roll it down. Push it up together. Now, once you're in position, open and close. The elbows will bend. Squeeze at the top and exhale. Two, slow and controlled, don't go fast. Three, feel that stretch across your pecs. Four. Five. Oh, I'm shaking because now, woo. Six, my muscles are starting to get exhausted. And seven, keep them together. Oh, roll it up. Okay. Now, this is the one arm underhand. Normally we would do two and squeeze the elbows back, but when we're using heavier weight, you can get more motion, more full range of motion by doing one dumbbell. So pulling it back and really squeezing that elbow back there. Okay. One arm, then the other. Okay. Squeeze it. Two. Hang. Your shoulder will dip down. Three. Full extension. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Shake it up. Other side. Yes, hands gradually every year start to ache me a little more, no matter what I do. Three. Four. Can't stop the aging. Five. Six. Seven. And make sure you get that full extension at the bottom. All right. Erica, hi. Okay. Recovery up on this side. One full minute. Remember, don't lock out your knees. And you're going to let it dip down. And then pull it up. Go the other direction. Down. Pull. Down. Pull. Oh, yeah. This is a great side knee tightener. Woo. Keep going. Tell you what, I love this mesocycle because we get to do abs every day because I always put abs in the other workouts. Whoop. And now we get to do abs every time we work out. Pull it down. I can't do it on the other mesocycles like this because the rest and recovery is much shorter. We wouldn't get very much in. Okay. Keep going. Pull it up. 5 seconds. Four, three, two, done. Ooh, I got a little crack. Felt a little crack in my back. Release some tension. Okay. This is total failure. Look at your number and make sure you're trying to beat your total failure weight. All right. Now, since I added weight onto my, I'm gonna try to beat my total failure. All right. I mean, I'm gonna try to get my eight reps since I didn't need a weight. Sorry, I was distracted. All right, so roll it back and push it up. One,
keep going. Make sure you're controlling it. Oh, it's getting hard now because I'm shaking. Just keep going. Oh. This is it for me. Oh, once I know my form is lacking, I have got to drop it. Okay, so I'm going to write that down. Oops. Sorry. Oop. Before I forget. All right. Crossover row. What was my total failure? Okay. I'm going to try to beat my 10. This one for me is going to be the hands. The hands are going to want to give up before I can't use my hooks either. Before my back. 3, 4, don't dip your neck down. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You're using your waist on this too. 11, I did it. Oh, man, I was just dying to get to 11. Okay, you're really using your core because as you're pulling that back, you're gonna feel your back core working. Okay. I'm so glad that's over with. Okay, put this back. I don't want to think about using that again. Oh, okay. Write it down. All right, guess what? Shoulders. Now, I'm not increasing weight because I only got 9. But that's all right. 22 and a half. Oh, and I get to use the same weight for the other exercise as well because I got 9 on that one. So 22 and a half I'm grabbing and we're doing an Arnold press. So the dumbbells, we'll start off with your palms facing back. Swing and press, and then swing the elbows back to the front. Swing the elbows open and up, and then swing the elbows back to the front. You can do this sitting down if you have back issues. Sometimes it's easier to hold your spine nice and straight if you're sitting. If you want to use a wider stance, tuck, squeeze your glutes and tuck your hips forward. That will help to keep your spine straight and supported, okay? Choose whatever you want, sitting or standing, it's up to you. Okay. 7, 6, I'm not resting at the bottom. 5, 4, squeeze your glutes. 3, 2, and 1. Ah, guess what? Reverse flies, I'm using that same weight. Write it down. All right. Reverse flies. So remember our chest press? It's exactly the same thing except for we're leaning down. So now we're doing pulling. We're pulling using pull muscle. Okay? Before we were pushing it, now we're pulling it with the weight. All right, so we're facing down. Palms will face together, neck in alignment. Don't shrug your shoulders. Open that fly. 2, 3, I'm stopping it at the bottom. 4, squeezing the shoulder blades. 6, 7, I'm not using momentum.
slow it down as you come down to the bottom. All right, recovery up. Okay, we're gonna reach up as we lift a leg. And I'm gonna use that 15. Again, you don't have to if you don't want to. I'm gonna use the 10 because I have my 5 pound weights on. I won't have to take them off. Okay. You're gonna alternate lifting the leg as you reach up. Now, take the arms out of it and don't be bending the elbows. Okay, just keep them stiff. Modifiers, go. Watch me. Knee in. Knee in. Knee in. Otherwise, reach it up with the leg lift and alternate. Exhale. On the way up, tuck your chin. Remember, we're not going fast. I'm not swinging my arms around. I don't want to work my shoulders. Let your core push you up. Use those abs. Just hang on to that dumbbell. Lift a leg and reach. Exhale. Tuck your hips. Ten seconds. Done. Okay. Whew. Keeping these on. Oh. Seems like grueling, but oh well. All right. Here we go. Round two. Four sets in this one. Again, whether you're sitting or standing, spine is straight. Here we go. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. So we're working the push on this move. And 1, the push on that move. And we're working the pull on this move. Okay. Catch your breath. Remember, stop it at the bottom. Don't be doing like this. Don't be bobbing up and down and swinging and using momentum. You're not gonna get, that's not what we're looking for on this. We're looking for control and strength. Okay. Face down. Don't shrug your shoulders. Keep your shoulders away from your neck. Don't droop your head down. 3. Open and squeeze. 5, 6, 7. Woo! That's all. Ay, ay, ay. Okay. Try 15. 5 plus my 10. Don't use your shoulders for this. Keep their arm locked, pointed up. Go. Again, pull a knee in instead if you want. 5. Remember your form. Think about the muscles you're using. Lower abdominal with upper abdominal together. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Blow the air out, tuck the hips. 10 seconds. Done. Okay. Now's the time. Anything that needs stretching. Oh. Oh, a nice twist. A nice twist. Oh, that feels good. Okay. Shake it out. Boy, with these wrist weights on, 2.5 pounds, You're really gonna stretch. Okay, guess what? Break's over. 7 reps, 3rd set. Let's go. Ha. But I don't want to. Woo. Here we go. Squeeze your glutes. Tuck your hips, support your spine, or sit. Five. One more. Yes. Okay, see, these are very simple gym style moves because we don't want to get all fancy and doing things that are going to really cause us to have an injury. We need good form. Okay, now we're leaning down. That's what it looks like. I'm not locking out my arms, keeping my neck in alignment. Squeeze the shoulder blades. Here we go. 7. 1. That's why it is good, you guys, to work out in front of a mirror, not for vanity's sake, but for the sake of making sure you're checking your form. I can't be there to see you, so I don't know. All I can do is show you what I'm doing, but you gotta be able to look and see if you're doing it. So having a mirror is essential for good form. How else are you gonna see if you're doing it right? Keep going. This is our last set of core. We have total failure. Okay. Only less than halfway to go. Don't swing your arms around. You don't want to work your shoulders. This is recovery for shoulders. 10 seconds. Done. Okay. Whew. Get this back. Guess what? 30 seconds to recover for our total failure. Shake it out. Anything that's tight. Oh, this feels good. Especially, oh, shake it out with these weights on my wrist. Okay. Swing it. Okay. Well, break's over. Last round. Okay, so now I'm gonna try to beat my total failure. Oh, 9. Okay, here we go. It's go time. Whew. See, that way you can always challenge yourself with your own numbers. You push yourself. 2, you're your motivator. 3, 4. That's 7. That's 8. Keep going. All right. Whoa. Hold on. I am out of breath on that one. All right. I'm gonna write it down. You keep going if you're going. Whew. Well, as you can see from just last week, I beat my reps too. I'm glad. See, I pushed myself just the same. Now I'm gonna try to beat my total failure for reverse flies. Again, you do what works for you, but I gotta keep pushing myself too because that's how I've been able to maintain my muscle for the last 15 years. So, whew, I've maintained my muscle, but I've increased my strength. So that shows you how the myth about lifting heavy weights makes you bulky. We're not working out for bulk. There is a way to work out for bulk though, but we're not doing it. Six. Ten, keep your spine straight. All right. I'm gonna leave that right there. Pretty sure I'm gonna need them. All right. I beat my total failure. All right. Catch your breath. Okay. Put these back. Don't need them. Now, I'm not increasing on my upright row. I only had 10. So remember, it's like you're zipping the zipper in front. Here's your zipper right here. You're zipping the zipper. Elbows lead. It's not this. It's not that. The elbows have to lead the pulling it. It's like you're grabbing something from down here and you're pulling it up. And you're pulling it up. Okay? You can also use a kettlebell. If you want to use a nice heavy kettlebell, Sunshine, and do the same thing if you have a heavy enough one. If not, like I said, two dumbbells. Okay, here we go. Two dumbbells. All right, now if you have to lean forward a little bit, you know, depending on if you're, it's gonna smack you in the chest, then go ahead and lean forward a little bit. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Again, as long as the elbows are just slightly higher than the arm, the hands, because the dumbbells hang down. You're pulling the dumbbells up. Okay, Y raise on stability ball. Now, if you don't want to use a stability ball and you do have an incline bench, you can also, Erica, I know you have one of these, is do this. Leaning down, okay? And I think, just for the sake of, I have the bench already ready, I'm gonna do mine on there. All right, I'm only using 5 pounds, as we saw last time. We're just doing a little detailing muscle. So we don't need heavy. This is like one of those great moves that I love to use in bar because we only use 3 pound dumbbells. So, you are making a Y. It looks like this if you're looking down or underneath me. Make a Y and lower it with control. Make a Y and lower it with control. Now we're pulling. Okay. Lean down. Now, one, and lower it down with control. Two, as soon as it's in line, arms with your body. Three, four, don't lock out your arms. Five, don't swing with momentum, I'm stopping them. Six, use your core, hold it. And seven. Now, again, I really don't wanna go too heavy with that move, just because it's a detailing muscle. All right, recovery abs. Slider, oh. All right, I'm changing it because I don't feel like doing the sliders over here. We're gonna jack the feet and then we're gonna bring a knee in. All right, so it's gonna be a plank jack. You can use sliders if you want. Jack, knee, and we're gonna alternate. Okay, here we go. You can also go tap, knee. Also, just to show you, keep going. Hands on a bench, straight line, tap, knee. Tap, knee, same thing. Look at my straight line, head all the way to toe, straight line. Same thing for you. Incline will be easier. The lower to the ground you are, the harder it is. So keep going. Hold that spine straight. Uh-oh. Keep going, I have low battery. Hang on. Sorry, warned me, low battery, sorry. I don't know why my iPad keeps draining every time. Okay, last one here. Sorry. There we go. All right. Woo! So there's lots of options when doing planks. I've already been through all the instructions before. Just remember, there's always an option for you to modify. Anytime you're elevated doing push-ups, it's easier. Lower to the ground, harder. Decline, even harder, okay? Pick your option. As long as you're doing it, doesn't matter. You're doing the work. Okay, upright row. Here we go. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. Whoop, whoop. All right. Squeeze at the top. Seven, six, five, three, and one. All right. Okay, plank jack and bring a knee into the elbow. Alternate. Here we go. Remember, tapping out is an option too. Tap out. Almost there, less than half. Last one, done. That was our last ab. Catch your breath. Shake your hands out. Shake your wrists. Okay? Reach it back. Get a stretch. Shoulders. Chest expansion. Reach it forward, child's pose. Let all the tension out of the back. Ah, last round, total failure. Look at your number. If you added weight, just try to get to eight or whatever you've got. If you did not add weight, try to beat your total failure rep. Okay. All right. There we go. Did beat it by two. Yes. Okay. Oh, good. Yes. Kettlebell's perfect, sunshine, because you can hang on to it the same with both hands, so you're not independently. Yes.
Woo! I remembered you had those kettlebells, Sunshine. And I, you know what? Seriously, for all the gym equipment I have, do you know I don't have kettlebells? I think that's going to be my next investment, is to get some kettlebells. Sometimes they're just the best. They're the best. All right. Two. Control it. Four. Five. Tighten up your core. You're working deep transverse muscles. Seven. All around your spine and your girdle. Eight. Ten. Okay, I'm gonna do one more. Oh man, I'm gonna hang my arms down here, but let's get up, we're done. Oh, we're finished. Sunshine, I'm so glad I had you for my workout buddy today. Oh my gosh, it's so nice to talk to somebody and know that they can actually hear you. So, we were doing our stretches in between all these exercises, so if you still need to stretch, go right ahead and continue to drink tons of water. Read that article that I posted in the featured pin about DOMS. You are going to feel soreness, and sometimes it is a little painful. Like, it was painful for me to sit down on my bum on Monday. It hurt. And sometimes DOMS won't kick in for maybe the 24 hours. So you might think, oh, I'm not going to be that sore. And then all of a sudden, 2 days later, you're like, oh my gosh, like my biceps are. They were not this sore yesterday, but yet today, extremely sore. All right, so you guys have a beautiful day. Thanks for joining me. Give me feedback when you do this workout. And again, that way you're checking in with me and I know that you're doing the workouts. All right, peace. See ya.